Hello, viewer. Welcome back to Artistry. Today, I want to illustrate how to prepare surfaces. We call it truing up surfaces or preparation of surface, because without good surface, we can hardly get anything done well in joinery, especially, as well as carpentry. Preparation makes a good part of our success right from the beginning. So I have a number of tools on my desk, on my bench, and I'm going to use part of them to smooth this surface and to make it true. True meaning it's going to be very flat on this side. You can see it is not planed. Then I call it the face, as well make a good edge, one of them, either this one or this one, and then call it an edge. So I'm going to demonstrate practically how we go about it. So we're going to use a jack plane for this purpose. The jack plane is a general purpose plane, as we said. And just to remind ourselves, we have three common types of bench planes. One among them is a general purpose plane, which is a standard plane. And then we have a smoothing plane, which is shorter than this one for finishing. And then we have a triplane for long surfaces. Since my piece is just moderate, it's neither too long nor too short, I'm going to use the general purpose plane for that purpose. So we ensure the plane, the blade is sharp, and then it is well set. It has the adjustment lever, this one, the depth adjustment screw. This one, if I want the blade to be deeper, to cut deeper, to cut more, then I rotate it clockwise. And if I don't want it to cut so deep, I want it to cut lightly, then I rotate it anti-clockwise. Then we have the lateral adjustment lever up here. So I'll just, once I take it this side, then the blade cuts deeper on this side. If I take it again on this side, then the plane cuts deeper on this opposite side. So for now, I'll set it at the center and have my plane well adjusted. Then I'll get a good position to plane. Then I'll station myself 1 foot, the left foot on the front, then the right foot on the back. Then I'll hold the knob. This one we call it the knob. And then I'll get ready for planing. Then I'll plane end to end so that I can have my surface smooth. End to end. If I feel it's not cutting enough, then I increase on the depth. On the depth. Remember, I said we plane end to end. So I'll plane with my eyes on the gauge line, because I'm not supposed to go beyond the gauge line. So I'll continue by checking my line. So if the shavings are too thick, I'm cutting too much and I'm wasting my energy. So I'll reduce a little bit and then continue. So I'm almost at the gauge line, so I'll go slowly now, checking it on both sides. So once I'm now nearer to the gauge line, Then I'll start checking my squareness using the face. The face side is this one. So I'll check for squareness. Almost good. Almost good. So I'll do the final finishing on that. Good. Now it's well. From there, I now make the final gauge mark on the width, on the depth. The width is this one, then the depth or the thickness. Then I'll measure and see how much I want. Let's say 46 millimeters, and then I'll put the gauge mark at 46. Then I'll run my marking gauge all through, turn my piece, run it all through. I put it boldly now with the pencil. I'm sorry. On the other side also. And then I'll plane it only up to that line. I can even use the bench stop. Bench stop is on the top of the bench. I can still hold my piece. I don't have to clamp it. Then I just plane. Then I'm almost there now. Good. My surface is now clean. I check it against the edge. And then this height there. Now it's easier to get this one in line because it has two marks on both sides. Once I plane, make sure I reach this gauge and this other gauge, then I'm done. So from there, I measure and mark for the length. So my piece is 754. So half of that, So mark for whatever measurement that I need. If I want to cut it in two, then I measure exactly half, and then use the edge to make the mark. Use the edge, make that mark, and then use the face to make the other mark. Very important. Then use the face again to make the mark on the other side. So from there, I'll cut using the bench hook. I'll cut for length, then I'll use a cross cut saw. So the cross cut saw will look like that. We categorize it in the category of hand saws. Hand saws. The tenon saw, we categorize it as a back saw. Back saw because it has a strong back. Now this is a hand saw. It will cut across the grains. So it's a cross cut, so it will cut right across. So I'll remove any tool or anything ahead of the saw. And now we have our pieces together. Now we have two equal pieces. So the last step in preparation of surfaces is shooting the edge. Shooting the edge. If you can see, the edge of this is quite rough. So what I do, I'll clamp them on the bench vise. I'm dealing now with the edges. And the anneal rings are very well visible on this one. So what I'll do, I'll make sure my blade of the plane is quite short, and then I'll deal with the edge grains. I'll make sure I don't tear off the edge grains at the end. So I'll plane from this side and as well plane from that side. So I'll keep my blade small. And then always make sure I'm planing towards the center so that I don't tear off the grains. So now my edge grains are well finished. This is the last step in truing up surfaces. The anneal grains are very well visible. You can see them. Now the only remaining bit is a bit of sadding. If you look at them right now, they look like they are one piece. They are so continuous. The anneal rings look so well visible. It is well finished. Now from there, it is a bit of sadding that is remaining. And our pieces are well done. So in preparation of surfaces, we have about 6 steps to review what we have done. So first, we plane the face and put a face mark. Secondly, we plane the edge and put an edge mark. And from there, we gauge and plane for width. And then we have sized our width. And we move on to gauge and plane the thickness. From there, we measure and cut the length, and then finally we shoot the edges. So that makes our piece now presentable for any kind of joinery, any kind of joint work. Now our pieces can be said to be ready. So we now can define the width. This is the width of the piece. We can define the weight, the depth, and then we can as well tell the length of that piece. So in preparation of surfaces, we have those 6 very important steps. Once we are through with that, now we can say we are ready to go. So for now, from there now we can go on to make any piece of joinery or any part of joint that we wanted to make. So basically that is the much that is involved in the preparation of surfaces, and that is the first step that we do in every given work. We have to make the selection of materials, prepare the surfaces, and then we mark out. Marking out, very important part of joinery. And then from there, we cut. Once we cut, we are able now to do the dry assembly without glue. We test it. We see if the measurements are all right, if everything is okay. And then we glue and clamp it. And from there, we do the finishing. The sadding is the little but the last bit of it, and from there we apply the finishes. Finishes may range from varnish to paintwork and so on and so on. So for now we'll stop at that, and then we'll move on after the break. Thank you so much. Stay tuned.